humanity is suffering from two very dreadful viral diseases. One is HIV/AIDS, another is the coronavirus. HIV/AIDS was discovered some decades ago by two scientists, one from France, Luc Montagnier, and one other from USA, Robert Gallo. After discovery, we apprehended that this disease may cause havoc and lot of people will die in this disease. But somehow with our social commitments and our physiological strength, immunological exercises, we could prevent the disease to some extent. And now, without a potent vaccine, we can say that the fear of HIV is quite less in the world. But during 2019, another virus came into existence, that is the coronavirus, which is much more dreadful and much more contagious because it spreads through aerosol. It's a disease which is basically of the respiratory tract. Therefore, lots of people suffered, died, and we have to go for several government measures like lockdowns and all. There also, we have some social perspective of this disease. We have to deal with this problem socially by means of social distancing. So I think if our society is quite aware of all these facts, we can survive this menace also. This coronavirus, COVID situation can also be overcome as we overcome the HIV menace. So we should be aware, and I think this NSS units should produce this type of programs as much as possible. This will help us to generate awareness among the future generations, and we will survive this pandemic also. Thank you very much.
World AIDS Day is held on 1st December each year. It raises awareness across the world and in the community about HIV and AIDS. It is a day for the community to show their support for people living with HIV and to commemorate people who have died of AIDS-related conditions or other conditions associated with HIV. As a community and as individuals, there is a lot we can do in relation to HIV. Working in partnership with people with HIV, we can encourage others to understand how HIV is transmitted. We can support people to access testing, treatment, and care. As we know that commencing treatment at the early stages of HIV results in better health outcomes and reduces the likelihood of onward transmission. On behalf of IQAC, Government General DP College, Singur, I would like to thank the Red Ribbon Club NSS unit for organizing this event online, for spreading awareness about this painful disease and shedding light on this topic. Thank you once again.
COVID-19 and HIV/AIDS, a societal perspective. The social and economic aftershocks that follow any public health crisis exposes, even though the entire population of the world, but the effects are felt disproportionately by different sections of the people. The situation turns out to be worse in case of people who are left behind or can be categorized as the marginalized sections of the society. Along with the direct physical risk, the psychological impacts pose additional risk to the mental well-being with the increase in the levels of stress and anxiety that such ongoing situations of uncertainty entail. The people with HIV or human immunodeficiency virus not only are at a position whereby they are at a higher risk of becoming seriously ill by COVID-19, but also as they experience discrimination and marginalization in society, it exposes them with a heightened risk of mental health challenges during this time. The dialectics of both COVID-19 and HIV/AIDS is that even though both are viruses and are contracted by the individual from the society, but again, once when the contraction occurs, this particular society takes up the role of isolating and thereby stigmatizing the individuals with such conditions. For COVID-19, even though it is limited or restricted to the temporary phase of virus contraction, but when we look into the case of HIV/AIDS, the stigma is for the entire lifetime. Social stigma, as in the case of discrimination, as we find, is attached to the contraction of COVID-19 by people, has been playing a major role in socially isolating people from others. For people with HIV, they face the issue of dual marginalization or double marginalization in case they contract the COVID-19 infection. In the current situation, national lockdowns, restricted movements and mobility, and closure of non-formal educational opportunities result in a lack of openings of social engagements of the infected with peers and educators. These have aggravated feelings of loneliness, depression, and anxiety in young people living with HIV. Studies on levels of anxiety reveal that about 70% of the people with HIV/AIDS reported to experience extreme levels of anxiety in the situation of this pandemic. Even health services, especially ARTs, that is antiretrovirals, which are considered to be very crucial in HIV treatments, along with counseling, have been severely affected by the COVID-19. When we look into advocacies that look for inclusive COVID-19 support services as well as social protection that are to be considered accessible to people living with HIV/AIDS, we must again aim to minimize barriers, also the social ones that hinders identifications related to both HIV/AIDS and also COVID-19. The approach that considers the human rights response to COVID-19, as we see prioritizes the already vulnerable population and reduces non-stigmatizing care and non-punitive measures for anyone with related symptoms of COVID-19 or HIV-related status. As now we hail the Red Ribbon as an universal support for people living with HIV, we must also come together to take a pledge to not only stand in solidarity for living with HIV/AIDS and also to commemorate those who have died of it, but we must now ensure that during these trying times of pandemic, the barriers which are both social and psychological be minimized, if not erased, so that we can proudly live in a society that we can claim to revolve around social inclusiveness.